fire of the same Spirit, and walk always as children of light, who our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, I will prove the holiness of my great name, profaned among the nations in whose midst you have profaned it. Thus the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when in your sight I prove my holiness through you. For I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you, and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your ancestors. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will pour clean water on you and wash away all your sins. Create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you. For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humble. O God, you will not spurn.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, Lord. Jesus again in reply spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent another servant, saying, tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fatted cattle are killed. Everything is ready. Come to the feast. So he ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then the king said to his servants, the feast is ready, but those who are invited are not worthy to come. Go out, therefore, into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find. The servant went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled. binding his hands and feet, and casting the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Many are invited, but few are chosen. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks so much. Of our existence and our life and our reality, it's about what we're doing. What we're doing, how we're taking care of this, and dealing with this stress, and dealing with that demand, and just one series of things after another. And some days we're good at managing all that, and some days harder to manage that and all that, and some days we are completely overwhelmed. But I think our message today, I will pour clean water on you and wash away all your sins, and the message of St. Bernard Abbot and Doctor of the Church is that beautiful reminder of the sacramental life of the Church and what God is doing for us. And that was St. Bernard's whole mission, was to help others to see what God can do for them and to be a minister of God's sacrament, to realize it's God working in our lives. It is God's grace. It's God that truly gives us everything. And God is truly doing something for us. Because sometimes we think, oh my gosh, God, where are you? And we struggle and we have challenges. There's a sacramental life in Mother Church here. He is washing away all of our sin. And he's truly taking care of us. So today, and again, I think it's an everyday occurrence. It's a good reality to come back to this all the time. What is God doing? Are you allowing God to be in the front of your life? That God is truly in control and truly understanding his sacrament. How he is washing away our sins, how he is feeding us and caring for us and literally giving us everything. Let us now stand and turn our prayers and petitions before the very throne of grace. We pray for Holy Father Pope Francis. We pray for Archbishop George Lucas. We pray for all of our bishops, all priests, all deacons, all religious, and the entire Church, 1 billion plus strong. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to all violence, and we pray for peace. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our three beautiful parishes of St. Peter, St. Joseph's, and St. Patrick's, and someday St. Mary's in Hubbard, that we continue to be a beacon of light, a beacon of hope in this cluster, and that we realize that God is in control, and that God will lead us through everything we're going through. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to the pandemic. We pray for the medical team. We pray for those that are suffering through this pandemic. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in gratitude for the rains we receive. We continue to pray for our farmers and all their needs. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our military. We pray for our veterans. And we pray for those that die in the line of duty. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all your thoughts and all your prayers, this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, bless our way to come to this holy Mass, to receive your goodness and your grace, through the intercession of St. Abbot, that we will continue to be like him, and trust in God, in faith and love. We make all of these prayers through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earthen work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, through the vine and work of human hands, and we become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We offer to your majesty, O Lord, the sacrament of unity and peace as we celebrate the memorial of Abbot St. Bernard, a man outstanding in word and deed who strove to bring order and concord to your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty God, and eternal God. For the saints who consecrate themselves to Christ, for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed
is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Yeah, as the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love, says the Lord. Let us pray. May the food we have received, O Lord, as we honor St. Bernard, work its effect in us, and strengthened by his example, instructed by his teaching, we be caught up in the love of the incarnate Word, who lives and reigns forever and ever.